So let's see if we understand the relationship between SMT and cache behavior. Let's say we have a program named A whose working set is 10 kilobytes. And we have programs B and C whose working sets are 4 kilobytes and 1 kilobytes respectively. Let's say our processor supports 4 threads simultaneously in the SMT fashion and has an 8 kilobyte data level 1 cache. In this case, we should run A, B, and C together, because all of them can run simultaneously. A and B together, we could run C simultaneously, but we choose to run it after we finish A and B, or we do A and B for a while, then C for a while, and so on. So pretty much we don't run them simultaneously. We run C separately from the other two. And the next option is we run A without using the other three SMT ways. Then we run B and C in two of the four SMT ways, but we don't run A together with the other two. The next option is run A and C together, then B, but don't do B simultaneously using multithreading when we are doing A and C, or do them one at a time, although we could run four at a time, we choose to run one at a time.